Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Here's the latest live picture of Old Faithful. Yeah, the camera is a little tipsy again today, but at least it's still up. Been watching it since it was still dark there. I noticed we got more melt along here in the front of Old Faithful. But here's the latest. That earthquake there that happened over in Japan definitely shook up Yellowstone caldera. I'll show you the signature. There it is as it came in at Norris Junction at the top. We got Little Thumb Creek, West Thumb. Looks like the biggest signature. And Yellowstone Lake. A lot of time these signatures are different because of the way that they're set, the microvolts that they're set there on the spectrograms. Here's the heliopots there as they came in. Yeah, we got Barbados, Grenada, Grand Turk, Cuba, Honduras, Jamaica. Yeah, it made the earth ring. Look at that. China, Alaska. You really cannot go by how strong the earthquake is at any given monitor. Like I said, it depends on what these monitors are set at. What is the microvolt? Down here we got New Mexico. Another one from Turkey. Antarctica. Look at that. Missouri. Thailand. Alaska. Oregon. There you go. Remember, every earthquake that is significant that the computer picked up would be marked in red. See them over here? This is borehole 208, West Thumb over here on the right, and Norris Junction in the center. So I want to click on this, and I want to go to the spectrograms and show you how it affected it. First off, this is the wave, and then we'll go to the spectrogram. There you go. Yeah, look at all the heat that came up and the gases. Yep. The last earthquake USGS has listed is for today, a 1.6 Townsend, Montana, right up there, and there's Helena. And then the next one they have reported is a 2.7 Stanley, Idaho. Now that was yesterday. Also yesterday, a Lincoln, Montana, again a little north of Helena, Montana. They've been having earthquake swarms up there for a very long time. The lithosphere has been damaged, and that's because of the rift, the mid-continental rift that goes through here. Then also yesterday, a 1.6 that was there by the lake. Let me zoom in for you. There you go. So there's the location of that 1.1. I believe the fault zone where the magma is trying to come up, dike intrusion of the rhyolite, is up over here. But this 1.1, there it is in Yellowstone Lake, 19 miles in depth or 30 kilometers. USGS loves to use kilometers. The United States never changed over to the metric system, even though they tried to do that in the late 1950s. So here on the spectrogram, there is the 1.1. Again, this one right here on the left is Yellowstone Lake. Look at the heat. Okay, in the middle would be Norris Junction, and then on the right is West Thumb. And we'll look at the signature. There you go. But there's other ones marked in red. 1715, now that's universal time. And we got more, you can see them all. 1704. 1922 and 30 seconds. 2156, we'll look at its signature because that's a little bit more significant. There you go. 549, we'll look at the spectrogram on that. All these, they're not reporting. And the most recent, when I pulled the files, was 17 and 30 seconds. Okay, well, look at the signature. There you go. All right, the borehole, a very deep well under the ground for Norris Junction. Borehole 950 for the last week. Lots of dots means lots of shaking, as you know. And the uplift is generally straight up. I've talked about that. And then for the last 30 days, yeah, the magma under the ground, remember that's this kind of a triangle. They're watching what the magma's doing. It's spreading and moving east. The borehole for Grant, which is on the southeast side of Yellowstone Lake, borehole 944 for the last 7 days. And that's been breathing. Look at that. And we'll come down to the disc. Yeah, it was traveling mostly east, but the darker the color, the more recent the earthquake. Looks like it's found a way to try and travel straight up, don't it? And then the last 30 days. See how it was traveling east and now it's just kind of going straight up? So, with this, and then this earthquake, and then Grant is down over here. Yeah, a little significant, I think. Yeah, the new monitor that they put in when the borehole stopped working is over in this location. Borehole 208 at Yellowstone Lake. Now that monitor is up over here. Up over here by Fishing Bridge. So 208 Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, and see how they set it different where you can't really see what's going on compared to this. And we got magma flowing east. The ground is tipping. I've talked about that. And then the last 7 days. Yep. Borehole 207 there by the Madison River area. For the last 7 days. Yep. Each dot, remember, each dot would be an earthquake that either caused uplift or for the ground to drop, subside. And then the last 30 days. That too has the trend of the magma moving east. X is north, Y is east. Borehole 205 for Norris Junction. There's actually two monitors at Norris Junction. Last 7 days. Look how it's getting wider. The reason the magma is moving horizontally is because of the rhyolite cap that prevents the magma from rising up. So it's got no place to go but sideways. And it's been doing that for a number of years now. But see, what it does is make the ground above the caldera very brittle. That is why you would not see a large earthquake for the eruption of Yellowstone, because the ground is so brittle. The strain meter, one of them, for Norris Junction. What the strain meter does is measure the pressure being pushed upon that borehole. And this is from yesterday. You see, we got one earthquake right there. All right, here we have the borehole for Grant, 944, and it shows you an example of channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, and 0. 0 is supposed to be up and down. So basically, channel 1 comes from the west. So there's pressure coming in from the west. And this one here shows it coming in from the west at Norris Junction. Now that should not be surprising, seeing how that's the direction where one of the plumes that comes in to feed the caldera there from the Snake River Plateau. The spectrogram from the Madison River area. You can see how deep the melt is. Not very deep. You can see where we got lots of hot water that came up and the different lines of melt. So here we have pressure coming in from the west, which is channel 1. The green one is channel 2. So that would mean it's coming from the north-south. Let's see if I can make that bigger for you. The spectrogram for Yellowstone Lake yesterday. These are always a day behind. And the one that's supposed to be right straight up Yeah, we know that's been ongoing for a long time, causing the tilt of the lake. Now, this goes back to February 12th. Again, pressure being applied coming from the west to the bore hole, and then we got uplift. But interestingly, Channel 3, the light blue, that comes from the south. What do we have south of this monitor? Well, that crack down there in the bottom of the lake where the rhyolite's been trying to break through. So here we have the uplift, channel 0, it just plain up and down. Channel 1, which comes from the west. Yep, I'm not surprised. So let's take another peek at that tilty webcam. Looks like we got two people out there walking. Yeah, the steam is currently looking a little dirty, huh? So that's all I have for you right now. Yeah, there's a lot of earthquakes. They don't report. Seems like activity is, getting more prominent. Well, that's not surprising, seeing how it is recharging for another eruption. So that's all I have for you today. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, thank you for watching. Yeah, I was thinking about the censoring that's going on at YouTube. Please stay safe. Always be prepared for any type of disaster. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you all.